What is this column? What is the name of this column? Sigmoid column. Heat is column descendens. Heat is column transversum. What is it?
It is.
What is the star? What is it?
Liver.
Liver. What is this ligament? Falciform ligament, okay, ligament of falciform hepatitis, and in anterior free border of falciform ligament, present what? What is this ligament?
Teres.
Ligamentum teres hepatitis, okay. And what is the name of this ligament? It is ligamentum coronarium hepatitis. Ligamentum coronarium, and free border of coronary ligament, heat is ligamentum triangulare sinister, heat is, and the same ligament on the right side, heat is continuation also, ligamentum coronarium hepatis, and free border of this coronary ligament on the right side has name ligamentum triangulare dextrum. Okay. Topography of peritoneal cavity. We know three stories, three floors in abdominal cavity. Upper floor or upper story, it is space between diaphragm superiorly and transverse colon together with mesocolon transversum inferiorly. All of this space, it is superior story. Middle story, it is space between transverse colon and two true pelvis. And inferior story, it is cavities of true pelvis. In upper story, superior story, necessary to know three bursa. Bursa hepatica, hepatic, it's from the right side of falciform ligament. Everything what on the right side, it is bursa hepatica, hepatic bursa. And on the left side from it, bursa pregastrica, it occupies left lobe of the liver, and it is in front from stomach. That is why bursa pregastrica, in front from the stomach. That is two bursa. And most difficult bursa, it is bursa, which present behind of stomach and behind of lesser omentum. What is lesser omentum? Lesser omentum, that is two ligaments, peritoneum, from liver, go to stomach, and all of this space, which occupy peritoneum, all of this space, has name ligamentum gepato gastricum. And heat is ligamentum gepato duodenale. And two ligaments, gepato gastricum and gepato duodenale, together form lesser omentum. And bursa, behind of lesser omentum and behind of stomach, has name bursa omentalis. Impossible to see this bursa in living man. Why? Because from large cavity of the stomach, peritoneum, go to transverse colon and fused with transverse colon. Heat is between large cavity of the stomach and transverse colon. Heat is fused together, five layers of peritoneum, and form ligament, ligamentum gastrocolicum. That is why impossible to see bursa omentalis. Only we can put finger into the opening. And name of this opening, it is foramen epiploicum. Foramen epiploicum, it is opening behind of which ligament? What is the name of this ligament?
Duodenale.
Behind of this ligament, behind of ligamentum hepatoduodenale, we can put pincet, or in time of operation, we can put our finger into bursa omentalis. And if necessary to perform operation on posterior wall of the stomach, necessary to cut what? Ligament between stomach and transverse colon, ligamentum gastrocolicum, we cut here. And after that, we can open bursa omentalis and form operation on posterior wall of stomach or operation on pancreas. Is it clear?
Yes.
It is place where we can cut. It is ligament between stomach and colon. Ligamentum gastrocolicum. colicum. And after operation, it is necessary to tie it together and restore this ligament. Three bursa: bursa hepatica, bursa pregastrica, and bursa omentalis. And necessary to know walls of this bursa mentalis, and walls of this opening, foramen epiploicum. For example, anterior wall, it is ligamentum hepatododenale. Superior wall, caudate lobe, lobus caudatus of the liver. Posterior wall, it is peritoneum, which come from liver to kidney. And from here, it is ligamentum hepatorenale. That is an inferior wall, superior part of duodenum. That is walls of foramen epiploicum. Next, medial story. Medial story of the stomach, of abdominal cavity. It has what? Two lateral canals, canalis lateralis dexter, between colon ascendens and abdominal wall, and canalis lateralis sinister, between colon descendens and abdominal wall. Two lateral canals, right and left. One of these canals is closed superiorly and not communicate with superior story. Do you know, do you remember, please? Because on the left side, we have ligament which formed pocket for spleen. And name of this ligament, ligamentum phrenico colicum. And this ligament, it closed left lateral canal. And right lateral canal, it's communicate with superior story of abdominal cavity. Now, space under the colon, all of this space, it is what? What is it? Small intestine. And mesenterium of small intestine, attached here it is from, it start from upper left side and go downward and to the right. And this root of mesenterium separates space under the colon into two sinuses. Here it is sinus mesentericus sinister, and here it is sinus mesentericus dexter. Clear? And last moment, here it is some pockets or recessus of duodenum necessary to know. Recessus of duodenum. Two recessus. It's on the place where duodenum continue into jejunum. Look here. Here it is duodenum continue into jejunum. And here it is two recessus duodenalis superior, or another name, recessus duodenalis superior, and recessus duodenalis inferior. Next, recessus in place where ileum insert into the sacrum. Here it is ileum, here it is sacrum, and above of ileum, here it is recessus iliocecalis superior and recessus iliocecalis inferior. Next, recessus behind the cecum, here it is recessus retrocecalis, and last recessus in loop of sigmoid colon, recessus intersigmoideus. That is all about medial story. And inferior story, that is space of true pelvis. And here it is necessary to know two excavatio in female and one excavatio in male. That is female corp, that is why here it is uterus. And between uterus and rectum, this space, it is excavatio recto uterinum. And here, excavatio vesico uterinum. In male, excavatio recta vesicalis. That is easiest part of your classes, topography of inferior story. And more difficult, superior and medial story. Yes? That is all.
You were asking in the inferior.
Yes.